Hope everyone are doing good. So in the previous class we have discussed about the spot fish and some types of fishes where they are living, and if they live in fresh water what will happen, if they live in salt water what will happen, we have discussed in the previous class. So now in this class we are going to discuss some again with shark. See, open page number 44 here. Open page number 44. Okay, have you all opened? Okay, see here they have given a picture about a gate whale shark. So this is a type of shark here. In shark only we have the sound, we had the name is shark. But in the shark also here different kinds of sharks are there which we don't know. We shall see now. The biggest fish in the world is the gate whale shark. So in the world, the biggest fish in the world is a gate whale shark, which can grow to nearly 20 meters, the length of 2 school buses. So how much it can grow? It can grow nearly 20 meters, the length of 2 school buses. So if we join 2 school buses, how much the length will be there? How much the length of the buses will be there? That much big the white-gate shark will be grown. It weighs over 25 tons. So how much the weight is? Over 24 tons. It have over 4000 teeth. How many teeth it have? 4000 teeth it is having. Through they are only 3 mm long. So how much long they are? So they are only 3 millimeters. 3 millimeters size of the teeth is 3 mm. The fastest fish is the sailfish. So what is the fastest swimmer we have discussed in the previous class? The sailfish. It can swim as fast as a car travels on a highway. So here they have given example of a car. How the car will run on the highway, in the same way the sailfish also swim in the fast manner. The slowest fish is the seahorse. So in all the fishes, only the seahorse is a fish which swims very slow. It swims so slowly that a person can barely see it is moving. How much slowly it can mean? If a person is looking at he can't understand that is it moving or not. So in that way it is totally moving very slowly. The dwarf seahorse, which takes about 1 hour to travel 4 meters in another slow moving fish. So the dwarf seahorse, which takes about 1 hour to travel 4 meters, it will take nearly 1 hour. And another slow moving fish, it even looks as if it is simply standing up, not swimming. So whenever it is moving, we just understand that just it was standing. It is simply it is standing, but it is swimming in the water. But when the person is observing it, that it will look that it was simply standing there. But it is very slow moving fish now, but it will swimming inside the water. But a person can see that it is simply standing. The most poisonous fish in the world is the stonefish. So very poisonous fish in the world is the stonefish. The stonefish is a very poisonous fish. Its sting can cause a shock, paralysis and even death if the victim is not treated within few hours. When we touch the stonefish, at the time in a few seconds we can die, or else we can get paralysis, or we can get shocked. Within few hours, if the victim is not treated, he will die. So tell me now which is the worst biggest fish? Yes, which is that? Again, whale shark is a biggest fish in the world. What is the size of the teeth of a shark? 3 25 tons. And what is the length of the fish? When two school buses join together, that much make the size of a game shark. So it is very biggest fish in the world. Which is the fastest swimmer? What is the name of the fish? Sailfish. It swims very fast in the water. What the example they have given? When the car is running on the highway or the road, how the car's speed? It will runs very fast. In the same way here, sailfish will be runs very fast. And which is the very slowest fish? Seahorse. Seahorse is a very slow fish. To reach 4 meters, how much time it will take? 1 hour. To reach 4 meters, it will take 1 hour. When a person is watching at that, do the person understand that it was moving? No. The person will think that just it was standing simply there. But actually, do it standing simply? No, it is swimming in the water. Means that much slowly it will be swim. So the seahorse is a very slowest fish. Which is the poisonous fish? Stonefish. Stonefish is a very poisonous fish in the world. Not only in the ocean, but it is in the world's very poisonous fish is a stonefish. Whenever it touches to us or we touches to that, what will happen? If we can cause a shock, or else we can get a paralysis, or else we will die. If the victim is not treated in few hours, what will happen? The victim will be die. So it is very poisonous. So how many types of fishes we have learned now? A game whale shark, and a sailfish, and a sailfish, seahorse, and a stonefish. We have learned 4 types of fishes now. Now next one. It is very amazing to know about the salmons. One more fish is a salmon. It is very amazing to know about a salmon. The salmons are born in fresh water, migrate to the ocean, then return to fresh water to reproduce. So here, learning of a salmon is very amazing matter. So the salmons will born in fresh water. They will migrate to the ocean. Migrate is nothing but they will move to the ocean and they will return to fresh water. When they will burn in fresh water and they will move to the ocean and they will return back to the fresh water to reproduce. In the Yokum River in Alaska and in Canada, certain haggard Chinook salmon cover nearly 2000 miles in 60 days. So here which river? Yokum River in Alaska and in Canada. The rivers were totally filled up with this salmon. How many? Totally 200 miles Chinook salmon. So these are the fishes named salmon. So in Yokum River, which is located in Canada and Alaska, the rivers were totally covered with 2000 miles of salmon fishes. In how many days? In 60 days. 60 days means how many months? 2 months. In 2 months, 2000 miles fishes were covered in the river. Salmon also have adapted to live in different water bodies like rivers, lakes, estuaries, coral reefs, and the open sea. Here, the salmons are adapted. It means it can also live in different water bodies like rivers, lakes, estuaries, coral reefs, and the open seas. In the water bodies, they can do anywhere. They can survive anywhere. Now tell me how many types of fishes we have learned now. First, we have learned about a whale shark. It is a very biggest fish in the world. And the second one is sailfish. It is a very fast swimmer. Seahorse. It is a very slow fish. It will swim very slowly. water. And in which river 2000 miles of fishes were located? In Yukon River, which is located in Alaska and Canada. In 60 days, 2000 miles of fishes were found in the river. So, can they live only in fresh water? No, they will take the birth in fresh water, but they can live in different water bodies like rivers, lakes, and open sea areas. In this way, they will survive their lives in different water bodies. How the sailfish will run? When the car is on the highway of a road, how much the speed can the car be run? In the same way, the sailfish also will run. And one more word. What is the weight of a game fish? 25 tons. What is the length of a shark? When the two school buses are combined together, how much the length will be? In the same way, that much length the shark length is there. What is the shape of, what is the size of a teeth of a shark? 3 mm. So it is a very biggest fish in the world, isn't it? Yes. Now, when the person is looking at the seahorse, do the person can understand the name of swimming? No, he can't. He can't. Why? Because he was very slow moving. To reach 4 meters, how much time it will take? 1 hour time it will take to reach the, to reach 4 meters. How much time? 1 hour it will take to reach 4 meters. When the person is looking at that, then the person will think that just the fish was standing simply there. But actually it is not standing, it is slowly swimming. And stonefish. When the person mistakenly touches the stonefish, it can, what will happen? It will harm to the earth. In what way? In paralysis, or he will get shocked. And if the victim is not treated in few hours, he will die. So that much the poisonous will affect to the victim. Now salmon fish. It is very amazing to learn about a salmon fish. Where it will take the birth? It will take the birth in a fresh water, and after taking the birth, it will move to the ocean and it will return back to the fresh water when it want to produce it. And in which river they have found 2000 miles of salmon fishes? In Yukon River, which is located in Alaska and Canada. So in 60 days they have found 2000 miles of chiffon salmon fishes. So in this way we have completed few part. In the next class we shall discuss one more fish left over. In the next class we shall discuss that. Okay, till then read the lesson, and if you have any hard work, underline that and copy to your notebook. Okay, my dear children, we shall meet in the next class. Bye.